Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's see another alkene addition reaction, the dihydroxylation. A dihydroxylation is exactly what the name says. It's an addition of two OH groups across an alkene. One OH group goes on one carbon and one OH group goes on the other carbon. Normally when people say dihydroxylation, they're referring to the syn, S-Y-N, syn dihydroxylation. A dihydroxylation in which both OH groups are added in a syn fashion to the alkene. The two reactions on this slide are both syn dihydroxylations. Notice that we started with cyclohexene. So it's clear whether the added groups are both up or down, or one up and the other down. Both products have the OH groups shown up, so these are syn additions. The top reaction involves potassium permanganate, KMnO4. KMnO4 can do multiple transformations, so it's important to specify that the reaction is cold and under basic conditions. KMnO4 is not the reagent of choice for dihydroxylations, but it still appears regularly on standardized chemistry tests like the American Chemical Society organic tests and the chemistry GRE, graduate record exam. The bottom reaction uses osmium tetroxide. Normally in catalytic amounts, tiny amounts, with an oxidant like hydrogen peroxide. The osmium method works very well, but osmium tetroxide is really toxic, especially to the eyes. So osmium tetroxide and KMnO4 are good for syn dihydroxylations. Is it possible to do an anti-dihydroxylation? Sure. You can't do an anti-dihydroxylation in one step, but you can accomplish a transformation in two steps. The first step from the alkene is an epoxidation with a peroxy acid. The second step is ring opening of the epoxide. I'd probably favor acidic conditions for this reaction, but you can do acidic or basic conditions to open the epoxide. Remember that in epoxide openings, the oxygen opens the ring by attacking from the face opposite of the ring oxygen. That sets up the two OH groups to be on opposite faces. That OH is up. The other OH is down. This is an overall anti-addition of the two groups. It's an anti-dihydroxylation. Dihydroxylations are regularly encountered in organic chemistry. They involve the addition of two OH groups across an alkene. By default, dihydroxylations are normally syn additions, but the transformation can be accomplished in an anti-fashion as well.